In this video, we'll be seeing how to integrate Razorpay on any project. This is the demo of payment integration. When we click the button, it will open and ask to enter phone number and email address. When we click proceed, you can see all the payment options: card, UPI, net banking, wallets, etc. If you complete the payment, it will show a success page. I have created a PHP page. Now we have to import the Razorpay library to this project. For that, go to razorpay.com, resources, developer docs. Now on the bottom, you can see Quick integration. First of all, let's check the documentation. If you scroll down, you can see the integration steps. First step, you have to create an order from the server. For that, you have to import the Razorpay library and you have to use Composer require Razorpay. We'll be using Composer to import the library. If you don't have Composer, simply search Composer and click the first result. You can click the download, download the setup.exe and complete the installation. Don't forget to add the path to the environment variables. After that, you have to run this command. Let's import Razorpay here. Open the terminal. I'm using PHP Storm. You could use any IDE. You just have to import the library to the folder of the project. So simply paste it. Now the library has been imported. Now if you check the project folder, you can see a vendor folder, composer.json, composer.log has been added. So let's close the terminal. Now open the PHP page. Here you have to require the autoload from vendor. Now this will add the Razorpay library to our page. If you open the vendor folder, you can see Razorpay folder there. It will contain all the necessary scripts in there. Now you have to log into Razorpay and get a key ID and key secret. After logging in, go to settings, API keys. You will see an option to generate live key. Simply click this option and create a new key. I have already created a key and I have copied the key ID and key secret. Don't forget to copy the key secret because you will only get it once. After that, you cannot see the key secret. You can always generate a new key and get the key secret. I have copied my key ID and key secret and created a variable key ID and key secret and assigned the values. Now open the documentation. Here you can see a function create is been called. For that, you have to create an object $API equal to new API. And inside this, we have to pass key ID, comma, key secret. Now, this API class is from the Razorpay library, so you have to import it. If you are using PHP Storm, you can simply click on the class name and type Alt plus Enter. Now, this will show an option to import class. Now, you can see a line is been added. Now that's it. You just have to add this line. If you are using any other IDE, simply type this line. After this, you have to create this order. Copy this line and paste it here. Now the order create needs an array which contain received, amount, currency. Now this is not necessary, so let's remove this. Okay, Now we have to specify dollar actual amount. Now here specify the amount. Dollar currency. Now I have specified the amount and the currency. Now we have to specify the receipt. The receipt should be always random. So I have replaced the dot from micro time, which is a float. So this will return numbers. Then a random number from 1 to 10,000. Then here you have to specify the user ID. This user ID should be different for each users. You should get it from your database and specify this here. You have to make sure the receipt is random always. Now you can specify the values in the array. The actual amount should be multiplied with 100 because we are passing here in paise. So you should multiply the actual amount into 100. Now specify the currency. You have to create a variable order to accept all the values which will be returned from this. Now the order contains order ID and all other details about the order. Just var dump order and let's see. Now you can see it contains order ID and the amount, then the receipt, and the receipt looks like this. You should change user ID and get this user ID from the database. It also returns created at, which is a timestamp of when the order was created. Let's just assign the values to different variables like dollar order ID equal to dollar order of ID. Like this, you have to assign receipt, amount, currency, and the created time. Receipt, order received, order amount, order currency, and order created at. Now you can change this like this so that you can change the created time to a readable form. Now you have to assign order ID to a session variable. RazorPay order ID equal to dollar order ID. Now you can close the PHP tag. Go to the documentation. Scroll down and take the step 2. Copy this form and paste it here. Now remove all the comments. Now you can see a form with action. You have to change this action to a status.php page. Now you have to create this page. So simply create this page. I have created the status.php page. And the method is post. Okay. Now you have to change the key ID. So you have to print key ID here. You can print in PHP like this. Now you have to specify the amount, currency, and order ID like this. Now you have to specify the order amount here, not the actual amount. And after that, you have to change this text. You can see this text. If you simply run this, you can see a button with pay with RazorPay. You can change this text here. So simply change this to something. Now you have to change the company name here. then just provide a description about the product or the company. Now here you can specify the logo of the company. Now these fields are for filling the user details. If you don't want to keep this, you can change this. So user will have the option to enter it by themselves. Now you can change the theme color here. Now I will show what the theme color is. Now if you refresh this page and click the purchase, you can see an orange color throughout. Now this is the theme color. So you can change it. Now let's refresh. You can see it changed. Now this custom input is for passing custom fields. You could pass anything here and specify just a value, and the name should be something that you want. Okay, I'm simply giving it C1. Now in the page status.php, you will get this one, which is a custom field. You can add as much as custom fields as you want. Simply change the name and then you can pass any value here. So that's how you can pass a custom field, okay, to the status page. We have completed the first section. Now you have to go to the status.php page where we'll be verifying the payment. Now here we'll be verifying the payment and deciding whether to insert the data to the database so that you could register a successful payment. Now for this, you have to go to this URL. I will provide this in description and you can find this inside github.com/razorpay/razorpay.php/test-app. Okay. Then go to the verify.php file. So if you open this, you can see this file. So we have to copy from here. Now copy this much and paste it here. You have to also start session. Start session. Then we have imported the API and a signature verification error that we are using here. Okay. Now remove the comments. Now copy the key ID and key secret and paste it here. Now here in the error variable, you can provide any default error message. Okay. Here we are checking the post variable is present or not. Then here we are verifying the signature. We are verifying whether the payment is legit or not. Inside this if condition, you can see if success equal to true. This means if payment is successful, you can print anything here. See, we are using a variable HTML and adding payment was successful and also passing the payment ID here. So we could also insert the data to the database here. Inside this condition, the payment is 100% successful. So you can insert the data to the database from here. Now in the else part, we are showing an error message. We are also printing the error here. We are getting an error message from here. We are printing it here. Now here you can see that inside the attributes array, we are also accessing the session RazorPay order ID, which we set in this page. See, now you can see the post variables and they have been created as an array and passed to verify payment signature. Now this function verifies the signature and the payment. Okay, and if this is false or if it falls to the catch option, then the success will be set to false here. Hope you understand how this works. And at the end, we are echoing the HTML. Let's try making a payment. I'm reducing the amount to 1. Now let's refresh this page. Now, if you want to style this button, you can call the class RazorPay payment button. Now inside this, you can give all the style that you wish to give. I have given a background, border, and a padding. Inside the page.php, we forgot to add session start at the top. So simply add a session start at the top. And inside the status.php page, we forgot to add the require option, require vendor / autoload.php. You should add these two lines on both the pages, otherwise you will get error. Now let's run and see. You can see that the style has been applied. If you click the purchase, you will get the payment option. Now fill the details, phone number and email. Click proceed. You will get lots of payment options. I am choosing UPI, QR code. Now I have made the payment through Google Pay. Now the page has been redirected to status.php and message your payment was successful is printed, and also the payment ID. See? Now you can replace this HTML and add anything that you like to add. You can give CSS and create a good status page. And if the payment was failed, this message will be shown. Hope you understand how to integrate RazorPay payment gateway on any project. You can implement this on any project. I have shown the core concept. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel for more such videos.